News 8 update. When the remnants of Tropical Storm Lee blew through the Susquehanna Valley in September of 2011, it caused widespread flooding and destruction.
One of the most memorable scenes was the flood water washing away a covered bridge in Lancaster County. That was it. The Siegrist Mill Bridge spanned the Chiques Creek outside Mountjoy for more than 120 years. Then this. Well, now, nearly 2 years after the storm washed it away, the bridge is being rebuilt.
For the past several weeks, News 8's Jerry Gish has been following the project and the rebirth of a part of Lancaster County history.
When the Siegrist Mill cover bridge was pulled out of the swollen Chiques Creek in 2011, it was just a shell of the proud structure that had stood since 1885.
When it was sitting in the creek, it was kind of heartbreaking. We thought it was gone for good.
But from the days right after the storm, county officials were determined to bring it back. And eventually, the bridge was dismantled, piece by piece. The resurrection started here, at the shop of Lancaster County Timber Frames. Pieces of the old bridge that were able to be salvaged sit next to brand new planks of Douglas fir brought in from the West Coast.
The fact that it's such an old structure, to be able to reuse as much material as we can, is really a priority.
The craftsmen here are creating the new bridge the way the old one was built. New methods mixed with the old.
We're basically rebuilding exactly the way that it originally was designed and built, with all the same connections and the materials, so that as close as we can, we're reproducing the historical accuracy of it.
The bridge's burr arch design is being reproduced.
Yeah, up in the warehouse are these vertical posts.
That means wood beams 36 to 38 feet long and joints that require exact cuts to the 32nd of an inch.
You gotta figure out and find ways and figure out the challenges, but that's what makes it fun.
This project is extra special for Joshua Engelhart.
I mean, I really wanted to do it.
He grew up on Siegrist Road, and the bridge was a big part of his childhood.
I spent a lot of time back at the bridge, me and all my friends. We fished, we rode bike. Lots of memories with the bridge.
Now he says he thinks about those memories as he carves the wood that will create the new Siegrist Mill Bridge.
It means more than any other project.
And in a small corner of the shop, away from the pounding of hammers and the buzz of saws,
it has a lot of meaning to the residents of the area.
Tony Zaya is working on another part of the historic bridge, the reason many of the locals called it the Scripture Bridge.
Know ye that the Lord, He is God.
Underneath the bridge, these Bible verses hung on pieces of wood, nailed in place.
Now this one broke in half. I'll be doweling that back together.
This isn't officially part of their contract.
You can see.
But Tony is still repainting, gluing, gently cleaning, repairing the Word of God.
I hope the signs and the bridge itself is as exciting for the residents as it is for us. We're thrilled about it.
Days later, the project moves to the banks of the Chiques Creek. The road has been closed here for more than a year and a half. Just an open space where the Siegrist Mill Bridge once stood. But it's close now to returning to its home. The pieces that were so carefully cut and measured are now coming together. As the bridge slowly takes shape, neighbors watch closely.
We hated to see it go.
Dale Martin has lived a stone's throw from the bridge for his entire life.
We spent a lot of time with the children and the grandchildren climbing through it over the arches.
And he certainly remembers the scriptures that hung below. You see, Dale's older brother put those verses on the bridge as a teenager around 1950.
He did multiple gospel signs. That was one of his hobbies, to paint them. And then he'd use scrap wood and paint it some for underneath the bridge.
We tell him the scriptures are coming back too.
Is that right? That's good.
The next day, Tony starts nailing the verses in place. This will be the Scripture Bridge once again. Another part of the rebirth of a Lancaster County landmark.
It's not only beautiful, it's part of the history. It adds to the charm of the county.
In Lancaster County, Jerry Gish, News 8.
Well, the next step, putting the bridge back over the Chiques Creek. News 8 is going to be there as a large crane puts it in place tomorrow morning. The bridge is expected to be open to traffic by July. The project is being paid for with FEMA and PEMA funding.